I regularly seek out credible news sources outside corporate media, and Real News is one source I've come to rely on.
More than 500,000 jobs were lost in the U.S. in November, the largest loss in a single month since 1974.
Payroll employment declined by 533,000 in November, with large and widespread losses occurring across major industry sectors. November's drop in payroll employment followed what were also large declines of 403,000 in September and 320,000 in October.
Though initially the announcement had a negative effect on the markets, by the end of the day, Wall Street had forgotten about it. The Dow closed up 260 points. The more than 1.2 million jobs lost over the past 3 months and the 11th straight month of job losses brings the total unemployed to 10.3 million. The unemployment rate is at 6.7%, the highest in 15 years.
6.7% shows is really an indication of their increase of who they count as being unemployed, because clearly, you know, those who are working off the books aren't considered unemployed. Those who are kind of been so discouraged and aren't actively seeking work in a way which the government can trace it are not considered unemployed. And then there's the huge aspect of those who are underemployed, who are working part-time because they can't find a full-time job. You find a part-time job and now you're no longer considered unemployed, even though your income might have been cut by 50-60%. So it's a small indicator of the economic crisis that is occurring. I think we can look at more so the kind of per capita income and really the kind of over the last 20-30 years the stagnation of income that most of the workers have faced in the face of great rising costs. And so I think overall, I'm just pointing out what a bad economic situation it is for most Americans, and this idea that we have an unemployment rate of 6.7 drastically undercounts the financial crisis that most Americans are finding themselves in.
And the financial crisis is real. As was officially confirmed earlier this week, the U.S. economy has been in recession for 11 months. Also this week, the Department of Agriculture released figures that show food stamp beneficiaries increased by 17% in the past year. That's more than 31.6 million, or one out of every 10 people in the U.S. receiving food stamps or taking part in the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program.
We've been hearing more and more reports about how food pantries are finding their resources are being overutilized. And again, the question I've had for quite a while now is there's been all this money put out for bailouts, but it seems to be a trickle-down bailout, where the idea that if we bail out the wealthiest institutions in our country, somehow that will help the middle class, working class people of America. And I don't believe that is true, and we need to really be advocating for something that will affect the needs of those working class Americans who are trying to survive in this economic climate.
There are times when reality just asserts itself, in spite of the haze created by television news and entertainment. Sometimes crisis rips a tear in the fabric of myth and propaganda. Now a profound economic crisis has ripped asunder the American dream itself. Millions of people losing jobs and homes. They lack proper health care and any real sense of security. Since 2001, workers' wages have fallen or remained stagnant, even though worker productivity has risen almost 33%. By 2006, the top 1% of households were receiving 23% of all pre-tax income, more than double what it was in the 1970s. It's the greatest concentration of income since 1928. As unemployment rises, we need to know why this crisis is happening and what we can do to defend ourselves. Why are wages so low? Why is the society so laden with debt? Is it in ordinary Americans' interest to have a $1 trillion military budget to project power across the globe? Corporate television news won't ask these questions, let alone try to find answers. Only a truly independent news network can tackle these questions with courage and with ordinary people's interests in mind. We need a news network that's independent of corporations, governments, and political parties. We need the real news. But there won't be a real news network unless we raise substantial funds right away. The current financial crisis has hit our funding hard. Together, we do have the power to turn it around. There are already hundreds of thousands of people watching the Real News every month. If everyone pitches in, we can build an internet and cable television network that will change the face of media forever. You can organize house parties, talk to friends at school and at work, send email blasts and spread the word. Distribute this video to everyone you know. Pick up the phone and call a few friends and suggest they visit therealnews.com. Invest just 10 minutes a day to ask friends and colleagues to join the campaign to create a truly independent source of internet and television news. Together, we can build this network. Just 50,000 people at $10 a month gets us to our first level of sustainability. You can help us reach this goal, and when we do, we'll move to television in millions of homes across North America. Help us reach an audience in the millions. Please contribute generously. Spread the word. Let's make the Real News Television Network a reality.
Your tax-deductible donation makes it possible. Please contribute at therealnews.com.